Another very useful tool in Shaper 3D is the translate tool. So let's say I wanted to move this bolt into this hole, for example. We could try to use our move rotate tools. However, for more precise movements, the translate tool is also a very good option. So the translate tool, very simple to use. I can just double tap on the object or body I'd like to translate. Search for my tools, it's going to be under more, and there I see translate. And now all I have to do is select a start point and an end point. So for example, my start point might be somewhere on the end of this bolt like that, and then the end point would be somewhere about here on the hole, let's say. And what's going to happen here is it's just going to translate my bolt from that start point to this end point. So notice that already I can tell this might not give me exactly what I want, because if I just tap the done check to finish it off, notice it has moved the bolt from that start point directly to the end point as I asked, but it's not exactly what I might want here because I didn't exactly specify the start point and the end point in the correct locations. So let's just undo this and quickly run through this once more. So I'll double tap on the bolt, go into more and translate, but now I'll be a little bit more precise with my start and end points. So again, I just tapped somewhere in the end of my bolt, but perhaps I don't really just want it on the edge of the end of my bolt here, but maybe I want it dead in the center of that back face of my bolt. So how I can get more precise with my start and end points is I can just tap and drag on the end point here, and now notice I can move it wherever I like onto a face, onto an edge, end point, and so on, and it's going to jump to those specific entities. So where I'd like it in this case is not necessarily on the edge, but right in the center point of this circular face on the end of my bolt. So that looks a little bit better for my start point. And then for the end point, I would like to put that on the face of the back of my hole there. So somewhere right about there. And again, if I'm not sure, I can tap and drag on the bolt itself to move it around to a particular edge, end point, face, or so on. In this case, I do want it right in the center of the face of the hole there. And then I also like to just double check, make sure this is looking okay in a 3D view. And yes, to me, it looks like it's going from the back face of my bolt to the back face of my hole. So if I'm happy with that, I can tap the done check. And now this is looking a little bit better. It looks like it's thrown that bolt directly into the back of my hole.